Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss synthetic fibers and plastics. This is your lecture 2 for chapter 3, subject science, class 8. We were discussing natural and synthetic fiber yesterday. Yesterday we have discussed many types of synthetic fiber like nylon, rayon. Okay, rayon is also known as semi-synthetic fiber. Today we are going to discuss about acrylic. Now what is acrylic? It is a man-made synthetic fiber, and if you have observed, the blankets which we are using in our houses are made up of acrylic only. Okay, so that is it resembles to wool, and it's an artificial wool because wool is expensive in comparative to acrylic. So nowadays acrylic is being used, which is a synthetic fiber, and it is giving more effective results than wool, and it is more warm in comparison to wool also. Okay, so you can go ahead with this one. Acrylic is a man-made or synthetic fiber. Acrylic resembles wool. It is also called as artificial wool or synthetic wool. As you can see in this figure, in this image, this is acrylic fiber. Okay, so nowadays this wool which is coming is of acrylic. It's an artificial wool. And now I told you that it is warm also, so it is cheap also in comparison to the natural wool. I have already told you, and as you can see, there are various colors of this one. So they are colored in many color dye also, and it is comparatively, it is cheap than wool. So acrylic is cheaper than natural wool and can be made in various colors by dyeing. Clothes are made from acrylic are relatively cheaper than clothes made of wool. Okay, so the clothes which are made up of acrylic is comparatively cheaper than the clothes which are made up of wool. You can see here, there is a blanket, and this is also again a blanket. These both are the example of acrylic only. We can get this kind of blanket also in the market, and this kind of blanket also. So there are different kind of blankets which are available in the markets, and they are made up of acrylic. And acrylic is used in making sweaters, blankets, other many clothes. So this has already been discussed. So it is used in other clothes also, for the winter clothes which you will say are made up of acrylic. Now we will talk about what are the characteristics of synthetic fiber. Few characteristics you can meanwhile yourself also judge, that whenever I was talking about any kind of synthetic fiber, I was always saying it is cheaper. Like for example, rayon is cheaper than the natural silk. So rayon is also known as artificial silk, so it is cheaper than natural silk, and it is durable also, more stronger also. And similarly with acrylic, it is cheaper than wool. Now, what could be the first point of the characteristic? Yes, you can read this. Synthetic fibers are cheaper, stronger, and durable. Durable means it will long. It is long lasting. It will go more in comparison to the natural. Okay, than natural fiber. And when if you have observed that the blankets are very easy to wash in comparison to the woolen clothes. So again, the second step will be it is easy to maintain, easy to wash, dry up in less time, and readily available. So it is readily available means every time available. It is it is going to dry very quickly, and it is very easy to wash also. So all these points will be included in this one. And synthetic fiber possesses unique characteristics which make the popular dress material. So if you have seen the popular dresses which the celebrities and the people are wearing in the weddings, the gowns and other things, all those dresses are basically made up of synthetic fibers. Okay. Now we will come to plastics. First of all, what is plastic? Yes, whatever the thing which you see nearby to you are made up of the things with like bottle, your pencil box, your lunch box, a fan, a table, a chair, whatever is near to you is made up of plastic. It's come in this category only. But plastic is also a polymer, and it is a synthetic fiber. Okay, and there are two types of plastic which we are going to discuss now. In the form of the types also, there are type of the how they are the chains and the arrangement of the units are there, because like everything is made up of something, like synthetic fibers are made up of polymers and natural fibers are also made up of polymers. Polymers are the chain of monomers unit. So everything has something, like we all are made up of cell. There are a lot of cells inside our body. So similarly, everything is made up of something, and you can go ahead with this one. Plastics is also a polymer like the synthetic fiber. All plastic do not have the same arrangement of units. I told you there are different type of plastics. Few are strong, few are not strong. Like the chair and table made up of plastic it will be different from your water bottle plastic. So there are different type of plastics. Okay, in some it is formed in linear, whereas in others it is formed in cross-linked. So these are the two forms. Few are linear and few are cross-linked. See, linear is a straight change. Linear comes for straight, and cross-linked is having a cross. So actually there will be a diagram also of this one, so you can like take help of this one. See, linear change, you can see there is a chain, then this is a linear arrangement. Okay, if you're going to put a one line like this here, then this will be wrong. You need to make a diagram like this only. Similarly, cross-link, if you miss any of this thing, like if you miss this part, if you miss this part or this part, any part you will miss, then this will be wrong. So these are the particular diagrams of linear and cross-link arrangement. Whenever it has been asked, it is there in your NCERT also, it would be a question in your test also, that draw the arrangement of linear and cross-link arrangement. So if the linear and cross-link arrangements are asked, you need to draw it like this only. Okay, see, plastic are easily moldable. Moldable means it can be molded, it can be tilted in all types of possible shapes. Plastic can be recycled, colored, reused, rolled into sheets or made into wires. So it could be done, but depends on the category of type of plastic. Not all the plastic can be recycled, not all the plastics can be reused, but yes, few of them can be done. Plastic is used in making toys, the toys which the children use, suitcase, the suitcase which we carry from going one place to another, bags which you use, cabinets, brush, chair, tables and many other countless items. Now coming to polythene. Polythene is actually, you are using it every day, but nowadays government has banned polythene bags because for the reason it is not good for the environment. This polythene is not going to get decomposed in the soil. It's a non-biodegradable product. So we are going to discuss about this biodegradable and non-biodegradable later on in this chapter. But today we are going to discuss with polythene. Polyethene. This comes from this word polythene. Okay, it's one of the most famous example of plastic which is used in manufacturing of carry bags. So this has been used in manufacturing of carry bags. So the polythene bag, the name came polythene because of this polyethene only. Now you can see the various articles made up of plastic. There is a lot many of containers, there is milk bottle of the children, there are toys, there is toy bike, like there is a toy of like bike, and there is a chair, a glass, so many things. These all are various articles which we use of plastics in our day-to-day life. Now what are type of plastics? I told you there are categories of plastic. They are thermoplastic and thermostatic plastics. Okay, thermoplastics are going to get bent easily. They deform on heating. They are made up of linear chain actually. Okay, and thermosetting are not going to bend easily, and they do not get deformed in heating very early, the one which we use in microwaves also. And this thermosetting is made up of cross-linked polymers. Okay, so they are long-lasting. They are going to get bended easily. So we will read about thermoplastic. Such plastic which get bent or deformed on heating are known as thermoplastic. Example of thermoplastic are PVC and polyethene. So you can see PVC stands for polyvinyl chloride, and polyethene, you know, with the one which we are using. So these PVC and polythene products are going to be molded easily. It is used in making, now what are the uses of PVC and polythene? PVC is used in making toys, bottles, combs, containers, etc. So the bottles if you are using, the toys if you are using, combs you are using, and the containers which you have in your kitchens or somewhere else, all are made up of PVC, polyvinyl chloride. You can see the varied article made up of thermoplastic. These kind of containers, like we all have, and this wire, all these are made up of thermoplastic because they're going to mold easily. Now coming to thermosetting plastic. I told you they will not get deformed in heat by heating. They are not going to get soft also. They are not going to get molded easily also. And actually, what is there? They are made up of linear chain polymer also. Such plastics which when mold once cannot be softened or deformed by heating, these are called thermosetting plastics. Example of thermosetting plastics are bakelite and melamine. Okay, melamine, yes, you must have heard this word before. It is used in the kitchen articles, the microwave cook utensils. The handles are made up of melamine in many of the frying pans. And bakelite is used in this also, the switchboards and all. So these are the examples. So these plastic are used in making hardboard, electric switch, handles of electric appliances, handles of kitchen utensils, floor tiles, etc. You can see. Melamine is a versatile material and poor conductor of heat. It resists fire, thus it is used in making floor tiles, kitchen materials, fabrics, and which resist whatever the thing which resists fire, it is made up of that. So if you can see any kind of frying pan non-stick at your place and there are handles over that, and that handles is made up of something like a different material, that is made up of melamine. There is melamine plates also available. There are melamine dinner sets also available. So they are actually used in all the cookery and utensils in the kitchens. It's a versatile material. Bakelite is a poor conductor of electricity and heat, thus it is used for making electric switches, handles of various utensils and other electrical appliances. Here you can go with this melamine plate, there is a switchboard of bakelite, okay, and there is a kitchen handle of one of the utensil, there is a steel utensil and the handle is made up of melamine, and there is a bowl made up of melamine, and all these things are used for doing these things, making these things. Plastic as a material of choice. Plastic has light weight, lower price, good strength, and easy handling. Being lighter as compared to metals, plastic are used in car, aircraft, and spacecraft too. So plastic is actually a very light kind of substance, and is going to the material is light, so that it is going to be used in cars also, aircrafts also, spacecrafts also. So particularly it has been chosen over the other things. Your homework will be today to solve question number 6, 7, 9 from NCERT exercise in your notebook. Now we are going to discuss Lecture 1, Chapter 3, Homework Solutions, which I gave you yesterday. Okay. Explain why some fibers are called synthetic. Okay. Synthetic fibers are man-made fibers. They do not come from nature. They are made up of petrochemicals. Now, coming to what are petrochemicals? Petrochemicals are actually the products of the petroleum. Okay. After the refining of petroleum, the products which we get are known as petrochemicals. Like diesel, petrol, all these are petrochemicals. And example, rayon, nylon, acrylic. Okay, so this is your answer for question number 1. Now question number 2, mark the correct answer. Rayon is different from synthetic fiber because it has a silk-like experience. It is obtained from wood pulp and its fibers can also be woven like those of natural fiber. So yes, what is the answer? The answer will be it is obtained from wood pulp. Why explanation? If you this is optional, Rayon or artificial silk is made up of by chemical processing of wood pulp. Because rayon is manufactured from naturally occurring polymers, it is considered as a semi-synthetic fiber. Fill in the blanks. Synthetic fiber are also called dash or dash, man-made or artificial fibers. Very nice. Mixtures. Synthetic fibers are synthesized from raw material. Which raw material? I just now told you, petrochemicals. The materials which are obtained from the refining of petroleum. Like synthetic fiber, plastic is also a polymer. Give example which indicate that nylon fiber are strong. I told you before that they are used in making parachute, they are used in paragliding, and they are used in mountain climbing, the ropes. And nylon is more strong than a steel wire. So similarly, you will get the answer also. Nylon is a very strong fiber. That's why nylon is used for making parachutes, rock climbing ropes, fishing nets, seat belts, etc. It is more stronger than a steel wire. Thank you.